Hi everybody, Paul here at Lake Erie Metroparks Marshlands Museum. And I want to take a couple minutes and share some details with you regarding binoculars. But before I get into all these, I want to highlight this pair right here. These are my dad's old Navy binoculars, and he used them in the 1960s. Fast forward to 1991, and I had a field bird study class in the spring semester at Eastern Michigan University. And I had to buy this specific field guide, and I had to have a pair of binoculars. Of course, you're a poor college student. Hey, Dad, don't you have some binoculars? Sure, so I used them. I can tell you with certainty that this pair of binoculars and this Peterson book changed my life. I can't even describe it. The opportunities that I've had, the places I've gone, the things I've seen, all because I partnered this very pair of binoculars with this book. So if you have a pair of binoculars laying around the house or in the box in the garage or under the seat in the car or what have you, go get them and let's get them fine-tuned, and then that way we can make them work for you. First thing to consider when you're looking at binoculars is there's parts and pieces and they have names, and it helps to know the names. So using this pair here, this right here is called your objective lens. That's what you have on like microscopes and telescopes. They have objective lenses. This is where the magnification takes place, all right? This is your eyepiece, and ultimately the light comes through the binoculars and comes out here. So this is pointing at your subject. This is pointing back at you. Objective lens, eyepiece. You focus it by spinning the cylinder in the middle. You'll notice that this eyepiece here spins, this one doesn't. This one's called the diopter. This is a big deal. We'll get to that one in a minute. You'll also notice that this one is taller than this one. This is an eye cup. This is the eye cups are down. And that becomes a pretty big idea here in a moment. So eye cups, diopters, we're gonna learn how to set those. Real quick, we also have the straps. It could be this really sophisticated harness. It could be an old shoestring. It doesn't matter. You hang it on your neck so you don't have to hold your binoculars all day. Now, there is a critical part to your binoculars that I can't show you because they're inside the binoculars, and it's called a prism. Now, as soon as I say the word prism, maybe, hopefully, your brain's clicking a little bit and you're thinking, I remember playing with prisms in elementary school, lab classes. And I remember physics in high school where we had prisms, okay? Or maybe you recall the cover of one of the most overrated albums in the history of music, Pink Floyd's Dark Side of the Moon. Ladies and gentlemen, that's a prism. And if you notice, the light coming in, it gets bent and then comes out as the colors of the rainbow. Well, here's the truth. Prisms inside your binoculars don't break things into rainbows because we don't want to see colors of the rainbow. We want to see what we see out there. So why are prisms in here? Here's why. Because in order to magnify the image with the objective lens, the image would actually flip upside down. So if you did not have prisms in your binoculars, when you hold it up against the bird and you're looking across the field, everything's upside down. The same thing happens in a telescope, but nobody cares if Saturn is flipped upside down. Nobody cares. It's space. There is no up or down. Here, there's up and there's down, and the prisms absolutely correct that. Okay? Objective lens, prisms, eyepiece, cylinder, diopter. Now, let's get into those numbers. Every pair of binoculars has the numbers. Everything that has numbers for a reason. This is a number two pencil. You gotta know it's a number two, otherwise when you take a standardized test, the computer can't read it, all right? Or maybe you're using something like the socket wrench here, the half inch. You gotta know it's a half inch because if you're gonna work on a half inch bolt, you gotta know this is gonna work. So the numbers tell us things in our life. That's how it is. The binoculars have numbers that are not there by accident. They have a very specific job. There's two of them separated by an X. In this case, they're 10 by 50. That's how you say that. You don't say 10 X 50. You say 10 by 50. The 10 is the power of the magnification. All right, it makes something 10 times closer. So let's say you're looking at a bald eagle in a tree and the tree's 100 feet away. You're using 10 power binoculars, 10 goes into 100, 10 times. It basically looks through your binoculars like your bald eagle is 10 feet away. These binoculars are actually 8 power. So 8 power into 100 feet is 12 and a half. So it's a slight difference. It's not really that big of a deal, but that's what the first number means. It's the magnification. It's cutting the distance. The second number, again in this case 50, is the distance across the objective lens. It's 50 millimeters across. All right, it's not inches or anything like that. It's millimeters. These are 8 by 42. So this is 42 millimeters across. Now, it's how they play into each other that becomes the big deal. We're going to work with a ratio really quick. It's very simple. You take your first number and you divide it into your second number. 10 goes into 50 5 times. So it's a ratio of 1 to 5. That's pretty good. What it actually means is you're getting a good balance between your magnification and the ability of your binoculars to grab light. Bigger lenses mean more light, okay? 10 by 50, that's fine. These are actually 8 by 42, which 8 goes into 42 5 times and then some. So that's a pretty good ratio there as well. They're gonna be good and bright. These are a little different, all right? It says here on the side, 8 by 22. So 8 power magnification, that's fine. But they're only 22 millimeters across. 8 goes into 22, not even 3 times. So because the ratio is lower, the light gathering ability for these is also going to be lower. Now, truth be told, if you're at your kitchen window doing dishes and it's a bright sunny day, yet 22 is not going to be a problem, okay? It's when you're out at dawn, it's when you're out at dusk, you don't have a lot of light to begin with, these aren't going to do much to grab that light. But as I've always said, dim binoculars are better than no binoculars, okay? So that's what the numbers mean, all right? Now, we've got to figure out what this diopter thing is about, and it's very simple, all right? Your eyes are not the same. Your left eye and your right eye are not exactly the same. So when you go to the eye doctor and they'll say a phrase like, your right eye is stronger than your left eye, what they're telling you is your eyes are not seeing exactly the same way. One is making things a little bit more blurry, and you correct that with your glasses. So what if you have two eyes and they don't see the same way and you're looking through your binoculars? You're just making the problem worse because now it's magnified and slightly blurry. So you use your diopter to fix that. Basically, it's working like a pair of glasses to fix your eye troubles. How do you use it? It's simple. First thing you're going to do is close your right eye, all right? And then you focus on a distant object and you look at it with only your left eye and you focus it using the cylinder, all right? That's step one. Left eye only, main cylinder, all right? Then you close your left eye, open your right eye, and focus only using the diopter. And then when you open both eyes, it should be crystal clear. You've got to focus on the same object so you can make sure your distances are correct. If you focus the left eye over here and you focus the right eye over here on something that's half as far away, it won't work. It's got to be on the same object, left eye first, then right eye using the diopter. Very, very simple idea, but it's a pretty big deal to make sure your binoculars are working for you like they're supposed to. The eye cups are also a big deal. These are my dad's, 1960s. There's no eye cup. So in the 1960s and 50s, manufacturers didn't even care. Nowadays, I've got eye cups that come up like this, or you've got eye cups that flip up. Why do we have eye cups? Because the binocular manufacturers figured out that some people with glasses are basically at a disadvantage with binoculars. If you wear glasses, your binoculars can't get up against your eyeball because your glasses are in the way. So the idea is very simple. If you wear glasses, eye cups are down. If you don't wear glasses, eye cups are up. Hard plastic, they twist, they lock, little rubber things. There's different technologies for it. It doesn't matter. But the principle is the same. Up if you don't wear binoculars, or if you don't wear glasses, and down if you do wear glasses. That way, everything is as best as it can be for you. Now, here's the twist. You set the diopter for you. You set the eye cups for you. You turn those binoculars over to somebody and have them look at the same bird, they're not going to see it the same way you are because you fine-tune the binoculars for you. You can think of it kind of like a car seat, all right? I'm 6 feet tall. My wife is 4'11". So when we travel and we switch drivers, the position of the driver's seat is very, very different. She sets it for her, I set it for me, and then we can drive. Binoculars are the same way. You set them for you. If you have to share binoculars, just make the best of it. Find some way to make it work. It get a little clumsy, constantly changing the diopters and the eye cups back and forth. Find a way to make it work if you're going to be sharing, okay? Once you've got your eye cup set, once you got your diopter set, you're off to the races. Go get a book, go online. The applications that you can get on your smartphones to help you identify birds, it's light years ahead of where we were even 10 years ago. But it comes back to the binoculars, which means this. You got to take care of them. Rule number one, don't drop them, all right? If you drop them, you are going to knock those prisms out of alignment. And if they're out of alignment, your image is going to be either blurry or it won't even be level. I have a pair of binoculars I use at home where the prisms are out of alignment. And the images are actually off center like that. They are not like this and mixed, it's like this. Awkward to use, I just close one eye and make the best of it. So rule number one, don't drop your binoculars. Rule number two, don't drop your binoculars. All right, if you drop these things, you're gonna break the prism. Rule number three, see rule number one and two, okay? Rule number four, don't get them wet. These binoculars I bought over 15 years ago. I've been out in the rain with them. They can manage that. My dad's old military binoculars, even though they're Navy binoculars, I don't think they can manage the rain very well. That's just my hunch. So if you're not sure how your binoculars are going to handle moisture, don't get them wet. Don't get them wet. Don't take them out in the rain or anything like that. Which brings the question, how do you clean them? Because when we clean things, we tend to get something wet first, right? If anybody in your house wears glasses, eye cups down, then you probably have one of these lens cloths that you use to clean your glasses. They work for binoculars too, all right? They work for binoculars. They won't scratch. Truth be told, if you're out in the field, sometimes, you know, oh, I've got some rain on there and I got to wash it off. You could just use a soft shirt. That would work too, all right? Cotton shirt, lens cloth, anything to get the grit off, all right? When it comes to binoculars, set them for you. Go have fun. Kitchen table, kitchen window while you're doing the dishes. It doesn't matter where you are. Your backyard, your porch, the Metropark up the street. Go have some fun. Life-altering equipment here. Thank you for joining me. And if you find yourself with some questions, remember we have our Ask Kevin segment where you'll be able to reach out to Kevin and throw your question his way. And if it involves binoculars, for example, he'll probably throw the question back at me and then I'll be able to get you squared away. And if you have any other questions, use that. Ask Kevin. Do it. Go ahead and do it. All right? So have a good day. Enjoy your binoculars, and we'll see you soon.